Hey everyone, it's Kill again, and today I'm on a quest. The smart Wi-Fi light switch I previously installed was a great quality of life product. Automating room lights is like smart home 101. But what wasn't mentioned in that video, because I only found out much later, was this really irritating occasional flicker that would happen while the light was off. After much research, I figured out the why and several options to fix it. Disclaimer, I'm not a professional electrician, and even though I DIY all of these myself, if you're not feeling confident, I would recommend engaging a pro. So first of all, is understanding light switches. Typically, there are two kinds of circuitry. A typical electrical circuit has a live wire from and neutral wire back to the power source. Add a switch to the live wire and you can now flip the power on and off. Pretty straightforward. A smart switch, though, is another device that requires power of its own. It needs its own neutral wire to maintain that power circuit. Unfortunately, most homes in Singapore don't come with a neutral wire at our switch points. Light switches in most homes are typically dumb rocker switches. The first option is, of course, to pay an electrician to pull another neutral wire to the switch. But these tend to be in-wall, and if renovations are already completed, it will be a huge hassle to do so. The second option is to buy a no-neutral wire smart switch. The Wi-Fi switch I was using previously is an example of this. How these effectively work are like dimmer switches. Instead of a hard on or off setting, power draw is increased or decreased. When the smart switch is off, there's only just enough power drawn to power the switch itself, and only a trickle of that reaches the light. This doesn't work for all lights, however. If you're using a low power eco bulb, that trickle of power may still be enough to power the bulb. So some of these smart switches include a capacitor to draw away power from the light during this trickle state. This tool, though, did not work for me. It might have been due to the decades-old circuitry in my house, or that I was using an 8-watt LED tube in an old fluorescent light fixture. But even with the capacitor, when my smart switch was off, the light would flicker occasionally when other lights in the house are turned on. This was highly irritating, especially when you're trying to fall asleep. There is another option, though. What if the smart switch was located in the light fixture itself, where it would have access to that neutral wire? This would definitely fix my flickering light for sure. So I bought this Zigbee Smart Light Switch module off Lazada. These are essentially the same as the wall switches, but there are no physical buttons, and they can only be controlled by a smart home system. With the new smart switch module installed directly in the light fixture, what I would now do is leave the dumb rocker switch always on and let this switch module control the light switch instead. I needed to purchase a Zigbee Hub to work with this switch module. But why have a gateway to control just one Zigbee device, right? So I ended up buying a few other items too to play around with, like this temperature and humidity sensor and this door sensor. I haven't set these up though with any smart automations yet, but they can be used as trigger conditions in the app. One more thing that I bought is this smart scene switch. It gives me back 4 physical buttons that can program up to 12 different actions in total, and these can toggle any of the automations that are set up in the app. These are more for my mum. Whenever she comes into my room now, and I'm not around, she struggles to ask Google to turn on the light or the aircon. So now she can go back to tapping a physical switch. And with that, quest accomplished. That's all for today. If you have any feedback or cool ideas for the temperature and door sensors, do let me know down in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.